Japanese Stories. Narration, Katie Haigh. The Battle of the Monkey and the Crab. A monkey and a crab once met when going round a mountain. The monkey had picked up a persimmon seed, and the crab had a piece of toasted rice cake. The monkey, seeing this, and wishing to get something that could be turned to good account at once, said, "Pray exchange that rice cake for this persimmon seed." The crab, without a word, gave up his cake and took the persimmon seed and planted it. At once it sprung up and soon became a tree so high one had to look far up to see it. The tree was full of persimmons, but the crab had no means of climbing it, so he asked the monkey to scramble up and get the fruit for him. The monkey got up on a limb of the tree and began to eat the persimmons. The unripe ones he threw at the crab, but all the ripe and good ones he put in his pouch. The crab under the tree thus got his shell badly bruised, and only by good luck escaped into his hole, where he lay distressed with pain and not able to get up. Now when the relatives and household of the crab heard how matters stood, they were surprised and angry, and declared war, and attacked the monkey, who, leading forth a numerous following, bade defiance to the other party. The crabs, finding themselves unable to meet and cope with this force, became still more exasperated and enraged, and retreated into their hole and held a council of war. Then came a rice mortar, a pestle, a bee, and an egg, and together they devised a deep-laid plot to be avenged. First, they requested that peace be made with the crabs, and thus they induced the king of the monkeys to enter their hole unattended, and seated him on the hearth. The monkey, not suspecting any plot, took the hibashi, or poker, to stir up the slumbering fire, when bang went the egg, which was lying hidden in the ashes, and burned the monkey's arm. Surprised and alarmed, he plunged his arm into the pickle tub in the kitchen to relieve the pain of the burn. Then the bee, which was hidden near the tub, stung him sharply in his face, already wet with tears. Without waiting to brush off the bee, and howling bitterly, he rushed for the back door. But just then some seaweed entangled his legs and made him slip. Then down came the pestle, tumbling on him from a shelf, and the mortar, too, came rolling down on him from the roof of the porch and broke his back, and so weakened him that he was unable to rise up. Then out came the crabs in a crowd, and brandishing on high their pinches, they pinched the monkey so sorely that he begged them for forgiveness and promised never to repeat his meanness and treachery. Japanese Stories. Narration, Katie Haigh. Momotaro, or Little Peachling. A long, long time ago, there lived an old man and an old woman. One day, the old man went to the mountains to cut grass, and the old woman went to the river to wash clothes. While she was washing, a great thing came tumbling and splashing down the stream. When the old woman saw it, she was very glad, and pulled it to her with a piece of bamboo that lay nearby. When she took it up and looked at it, she saw that it was a very large peach. She then quickly finished her washing and returned home, intending to give the peach to her old man to eat. When she cut the peach in two, out came a child from the large kernel. Seeing this, the old couple rejoiced and named the child Momotaro, or Little Peachling, because he came out of a peach. As both the old people took good care of him, he grew and became strong and enterprising. So the old couple had their expectations raised and bestowed still more care on his education. Momotaro, finding that he excelled everybody in strength, determined to cross over to the island of the devils, take their riches, and come back. He at once consulted with the old man and the old woman about the matter, and got them to make him some dumplings. These he put in his pouch. Besides this, he made every kind of preparation for his journey to the island of the devils and set out. Then, first a dog came to the side of the way and said,
"Momotaro, what have you there hanging at your belt?"
He replied, "I have some of the very best Japanese millet dumplings."
"Give me one and I will go with you," said the dog.
So Momotaro took a dumpling out of his pouch and gave it to the dog. Then a monkey came and got one the same way. A pheasant also came flying and said, "Give me a dumpling too, and I will go along with you." So all three went along with him. In no time they arrived at the island of the devils, and at once broke through the front gate, Momotaro first, then his three followers.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.